Do you look like your mother or father? Good morning, Grandma. Can you please comb my hair? Ma said some relatives are coming home from the town. She wanted us to get ready quickly.
Good morning, Minu. Come, sit down. I know Sita's family is coming home. It is many, many years since we met them. Her granddaughter has recently had her second baby.
Her granddaughter had a baby? Are they also coming, Grandma? Is the baby also coming?
Yes, Chinu. They are all coming home. But be careful with the baby. It is really very small. So, you can't carry it.
Okay, Grandma. But you will have to tell Buzz not to go near the baby. Otherwise, he will buzz in the baby's ears. The baby will start crying then.
I am not that stupid, Chinu. I will not go near the baby.
Minu, give me the oil first. Minu, your hair is thick, silky and black. Just like my sister's hair.
Your sister's hair, Grandma? How can Minu have hair like your sister?
Arey, Chinu, it is just like my sister's. My hair was thin, limp and brown. All my sons and daughters, including your father, did not have thick black hair. I loved my sister's hair. It was thick, silky and black. Even her children do not have hair like her. Now, Minu has hair like her.
Grandma, this is so funny. Minu has hair like your sister.
Why not, Buzz?
But Grandma, she is a distant relative. How come I have hair like your sister? I thought we take treats only from close family relatives.
That is the funny part. We take some trait or the other from someone in the family. They could be a distant relative also. My father used to make fun of my walk. He used to tell me that I walk like his grandmother's sister's daughter.
Oh my God! Your father's grandmother's sister's daughter? I am so confused.
Even I'm so confused, Buzz. The way you said it.
Grandma, that is so distant. I can't believe this.
But that is how it is. Okay, your hair is done, Minu. I'm going inside to help your mother in the kitchen. Our guests should be coming any moment.
Minu, Chinu, our guests have come. Our guests have come. Sita Aunty's family has come.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning. I will go tell Ma and Grandma that everyone has come. Ma, Ma, your cousin sister has come. Oh my God, she looks just like you.
Ma, come out quickly. Our guests have come. Your cousin sister has come. She looks just like you.
Oh, children, first, Let us go and meet them. Hello, Sita. Hello, Ramlalji. How are you? It is such a long time since we met.
Hello, everyone. Meenu and Chinu have grown so much. I saw them as little babies.
Yes, even Rekha has grown up so much. She also has babies now. Oh, the little one looks so cute. Rekha, give the baby to me. Let me carry her.
Hello, Rekha auntie. You look just like my mother. Even though you are cousins, you look like real sisters.
Meenu, in fact, Rekha is your cousin, not your mother's.
How, Grandma? Rekha auntie has babies. I thought she will be Ma's cousin because she is much older than us.
Are children, Rekha is your cousin. Sita is your grandmother's sister. So, Sita is your Ma's aunt.
Grandmother's sister? Then, is she a sister, Grandma?
No, Sita is not my sister. I am not the only grandmother for Chinu and Meenu. Sita is your Ma's mother's sister. Just like Meenu is your grandmother's granddaughter, Rekha is Sita's granddaughter. So, Rekha is your cousin and not your Ma's.
I can't believe this, Grandma. Rekha auntie looks so much like Ma that anyone would say that they are real sisters.
Do you know something now? Chinu, you are this little baby's uncle.
Chinu is an uncle? How?
That's because Chinu and Meenu are Rekha's cousins. So, they have become auntie and uncle for this cute little baby.
Chinu uncle.
Buzz, stop it now. I will start calling you grandfather.
Buzz, stop it. Grandma, if Rekha auntie is our cousin, how is she so much older than us?
Oh, it happens many times in many families. Rekha's mother was the eldest in her family, and your mother the youngest in her family. So, Rekha's mother got married much earlier than your mother. Rekha is her mother's firstborn. That is why she is much older than both of you. So, you have become an auntie and an uncle even though you are so young.
I know, Grandma. It happens in some families. Even my friend Sheila has a niece like this. So, she is also an auntie.
Oh my God! Chinu, you sneeze just like your grandfather. If my eyes were closed, I would have thought that your grandfather was here. You sneeze loudly like him. Even I can hear you.
Oh, is that so? I didn't know how my grandfather sneezed. Do we take traits like sneezing from people in the family?
Oh, your grandfather had this funny way of sneezing just like you do. It is so amazing to see how people take small traits from some family members.
Grandma, why does Babulal uncle speak
speak so loudly? Does he think I cannot hear properly?
No, my child. Didn't you notice that machine in his ear? It is his hearing aid.
What is a hearing aid, Grandma? What does it do?
That is a machine that helps him to hear. Babulal cannot hear well without the machine. Since he cannot hear well, he speaks loudly. He thinks he should speak loudly for others to hear.
That is sad, Grandma. Has it been like this since birth?
No. When he was 12 years old, he had an accident. He hurt his ears. He couldn't hear properly since then. Then, his parents moved to Nagpur when he was 25 years old. They got him a hearing aid then. Since then, he uses it.
Oh, so he can hear only with the help of a hearing aid? That is why he speaks so loudly.
Grandma, Grandma, look here. Look at the baby. It is moving its little toe alone, just like Chinu does. Chinu, look here. Look at the baby's feet. It's moving its little toe just like you do.
Meenu, can't you move your little toe?
Baz, Meenu can move her little toe, but not alone. Meenu, stretch your toes and move your little toe. Now let me do it.
Oh my goodness, all the toes are moving for Meenu. But Chinu, for you only the little toe is moving. The baby is also moving its toe like you.
See, I told you that these things are amazing. How we tend to take traits from the family.
Oh Meenu, you can't move your toe alone like Chinu.
But Buzz, I can move my ears. Chinu can't. Look, I can move my ears. Not many can.
Meenu, look, I can. I can move my ears just like you do. I don't think anyone else here can move their ears like us. So you have got this trait from me.
It's so funny. Only Sita Aunty and Meenu can move their ears.
Okay, come all of you. Let us sit outside for a while. There is a nice breeze blowing outside.
Balala doodh paazle ka?
Sita Aunty, what did you tell Rekha Aunty? I couldn't understand. Was it a different language?
Yes, Chinu. It is Marathi language. We have been living in Nagpur for many years now. Rekha was born there, so all of us can speak Marathi very well.
Nagpur? Where is that? Why do they speak Marathi there?
Buzz, go get your map. I will show it to you. Look, this is Nagpur. It is in the state of Maharashtra. Marathi is the language in the state of Maharashtra. That is why they speak Marathi language.
Oh, Maharashtra. I know that Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra.
Your little bee is very intelligent, Meenu.
Sita Aunty, my name is Buzz.
Oh, okay, Baz. You are very smart.
Thank you, thank you.
So, Sita Aunty, you don't speak Hindi?
We do speak Hindi, Meenu. We know both Hindi and Marathi. In fact, Rekha also knows English and Gujarati.
Gujarati? How?
That is because when she went to school, she had lots of Gujarati friends there. And she learned from them.
Oh, that must be fun. Rekha auntie can speak so many languages.
Don't you think even this is amazing? We get so many traits from different family members which come to us unknowingly. But we also learn so much from the environment that we live in.
You are right, Grandma. My friend Lakshmi has come from Chennai. She says her ma or grandma do not know how to knit. She says that it is warm in Chennai throughout the year and they don't need to wear any woolen clothes. But look at you, Grandma. You can knit so beautifully.
I learnt it from my mother. It used to be very cold in the place where we lived. So we had to wear sweaters. That's how I learned to knit. See, we learn so many things because of the place we live in also, like language, culture and customs. Minu, who is going there? Is it the new bride, Radha, and her husband? Just call her here. Hello, Radha. How are you?
I'm fine, Grandma. Hello, everyone.
Radha, these are our guests. Sita, Radha is the new bride who has come to our village. Where are you both coming from, Radha?
Grandma, Grandma, how do I tell you?
Radha, what is the matter? Don't be shy. Maybe I can help you. You look happy yet shy. What is it?
Grandma, we went to meet the lady doctor in our village hospital. See, I was affected with polio, Grandma. We were worried that if we had children, even they will have polio.
Oh, stupid girl. Who told you that polio is hereditary? Your parents were careless and did not give you polio drops when you were a baby. Will you also be careless?
Never, Grandma. That is what the doctor also said. That's why I'm happy. I got to know that polio is not hereditary. A baby will not get it just because its mother or someone else in the family has polio. The doctor said, my child will never get polio if I give it polio drops when it's born.
She is completely right, Radha. See, even Rekha is very particular about the polio dates. We give polio drops to our little one also. It is given free by the government in all its hospitals. They announce special dates for that. Radha, just a few drops will save your baby. Your child will never get polio and doesn't have to suffer like you.
That was worrying me, Grandma. Now I'm happy. I know that if I just follow the dates and give my baby free polio drops, my baby will never get polio. This disease is not hereditary. It comes just because of the carelessness of the parents. Thank you, Grandma. We have to go now. Bye.
Bye, Radha. Be careful and think sensibly.
Grandma, so people will not get diseases like polio just because someone else in the family has it?
No, Buzz, they don't. Sita, look at this little one. He has such long legs and arms. I think he is going to grow tall like his father.
Grandma, does this also happen? If his father is tall, then can the baby also grow as tall?
Not necessarily always. Like I said, we can take any trait even from distant relatives. Sometimes we could have eyes like some cousins or grow tall like someone.
Or have hair like a distant relative, just like Minu has. Grandma, I think we animals also take traits like that. Have you seen Raja's parents?
Raja just looks like his mother.
Yes, Raja's mother had 7 babies. 4 babies had color like her and 3 babies like their father. They did not even have mixed colors.
That is what a little boy like you found out nearly 200 years ago, Chino.
A little boy like me? What was his name?
His name was Gregor Mendel. He was born in a poor farmer's family in Austria.
I know Austria. It is a country in Europe.
Europe? Where is that?
Let me open my atlas. This is the world map. Can you see India here, Buzz? This is Austria.
Oh, now I know Austria. Grandma, please continue the story.
Gregor Mendel was very interested in plants. For 7 full years, he kept observing them. He observed pea plants closely. Then he discovered something special. He found out that a pea plant has some traits that come in pairs.
What does that mean, Grandma?
Like the seed is either rough or smooth. It is either green or yellow. Then the height of the plant is either tall or short. It is never in between any of these.
That is funny! How can it be?
Just like you observed in Raja's brothers and sisters. In pea plant also, the next generation was just like the earlier one. It did not have mixed seeds.
Mixed seeds? What is that?
That means the seed was either rough or smooth, but never half rough and half smooth.
Oh, like that. So, Grandma, even animals and plants take traits from their family? Friends, don't you think all this is funny? We get some traits from our family, some we learn from the environment we live in.
Some traits, like Babulal uncle, we get because of illness or old age. But all these make each one of us very special. Have you observed anything like this in your family?
Let us help Buzz to match the languages with the states that they are spoken in. Marathi, Maharashtra, Gujarati, Gujarat, Tamil, Tamil Nadu, Telugu, Andhra Pradesh, Kashmiri, Jammu and Kashmir, Mizo, Mizoram, Malayalam,
केरला।
बंगाली
वेस्ट बंगाल,
पंजाबी
पंजाब,
कन्नड़ा
कर्नाटका।
Will you help Parrot to know which of the following statements are true and which are false? Polio is inherited from family members.
False.
We acquire some traits from our family members.
True.
Pea plant has some traits that come in pairs.
True.
Polio can be easily prevented by giving polio drops to babies.
True.
Hearing aid helps a person to see better.
False.
Polio drops are given free of cost in all government hospitals and health centers.
True.
Shall we answer the following questions now? Do people take certain traits from their family members?
Yes, people do take certain traits from some family members.
What are the traits that we normally get from our family members?
We can inherit height, the type of hair or color of eye, voice, and sometimes even certain habits.
Do we get all our traits from our family members?
No, we get some traits by birth from different members of our family.
We can also learn a lot from the environment we live in.
So we take some traits from the environment we grew up in also.
Do you know what a hearing aid is? Who uses it? A hearing aid is a machine that is used by people who cannot hear well. It is kept in the ear and helps them to hear clearly. Do you know what polio is? Polio is a disease that is caused by a virus. The legs of a person get affected when infected by the polio virus. Is polio inherited from family members? No, polio is never inherited from family members. It is caused when the body is infected by a virus that causes polio. Can polio be prevented? Yes. Polio can be easily prevented by giving newborn babies a few drops of the polio medicine. It is available free of cost in all government hospitals and health centers. Who was Gregor Mendel? Gregor Mendel discovered that pea plants had some traits that came in pairs. The pea seeds were rough or smooth, green or yellow, and the height of the pea plant was either tall or short. He discovered that the next generation of the plant also had similar traits and never a mixed or an in-between trait. Friends, do you have any habit or trait that is similar to any of your family members? What is it? Who is it similar to? Can you make a table in your notebook like this and fill it up? It's lots of fun. Your special habit or trait? Who is it similar to?